Steve Dotto here. Today's topic, multiple Google accounts. Many of us have many Google accounts, and we've all had to come up with different strategies for dealing with multiple accounts at the same time, because, of course, we want access to all of our accounts at any one time. But the challenge is, all of our Google accounts we access through web browsers. And the nature of the web browser is to theoretically make things convenient for us. So here's what happens. Let's say you've got a personal and a business Gmail account. So you've got the business one open and you're working away, so you've signed into the business account, but now you want to check your personal Gmail. Well, there's a variety of different ways that you can do that, but for most part, you just like to be able to pop into another browser window, open your Gmail, and check it. You can't do that because as soon as you open Gmail in another browser window, the browser recognizes you're already signed into Gmail and it just opens another session of the same logon. Now, Google has given us a few tools for logging on with different users, and those are improving, but they're still not quite perfect. So we've come up with some different strategies for dealing with multiple accounts. Now, I'm going to talk to you about four different strategies, ranging from not so great to just okay. There's no fantastic way to deal with this. And I'm also not going to spend a lot of time now talking about some of the other strategies we can do, such as making all of your email flow into a single unified email account, which is kind of a whole different story. This right now is just about basically living in a web browser environment and managing those multiple accounts. So what is the most basic and simple way to deal with it? Well, for me, I actually had three Google accounts I like to use. And so fortunately, there's three decent browsers on the market, at least there's probably more, but three that I use. So I would open one account in Chrome, one account in Firefox, and one account in Safari. Now, the bonus is that I know by which account, which browser I'm in, I automatically know which Google account I'm in. The downside is it uses up a lot of system resources. It's not really an efficient way to do things, but that is one way that you can work. Now, the next way is a tool that Google has given us. Over the time, they've given us the ability to have multiple sessions and log in. And all that we have to do there is we have to enable our account for multiple login, and we can then have our different accounts running in the same browser. So here I've got my personal one, and here I've got one that I've got for some publicity that I do for a local theater company. So I can switch from one to the other just as easy as switching there, and you can see the new one is in. If I want to log into another account, I can just add an account here, and I've got a brand new account that I've just set up for some seminars we're doing. So I'm going to type in that username. It's in the password. And Bob's your uncle. Now I've got three sessions going all in the same browser window. Now this works well for most things and most basic applications. This is just fine. But there's certain times that you're going to have little conflicts, and sometimes you'll just pop out of one for no apparent reason. That's the nature of Google. But this is a pretty good solution, and one that most people are going to embrace. The other two solutions that I want to show you are far more creative. The first one is using a browser like Chrome, but instead of opening regular sessions, if you right-click on Chrome on the icon, you can open an Incognito window. What that will do is it will open a window in a new tab, which has got this little kind of spy icon on it. And this allows us to open a browser window that's not being tracked in any way, shape, or form. Now, I'm sure you can think of lots of different uses for this, but the beauty in this particular case is you open each one of these tabs, you put in, you log into Google, and then you enter you sign in with each of your accounts and you open multiple incognito windows. They don't talk to each other, so right within the same browser, you can have multiple windows open running your different Google accounts. This is a very simple and elegant way to do it, and actually one of my favorites. The downside, each time you restart your browser, you have to re-sign into your accounts as you move along. Now, the last one is kind of the most creative, but it took a little bit of finicking to get there. There is a program out there on the Mac called Fluid. Now, Fluid is a... Here's a... But way to best describe it. Let me go to their website. Fluid App. FLUI Fluid App. There they are. FluidApp.com. This is their tagline. Turn your favorite web apps into real Mac apps. So here's what happens. They take a web 2.0 page or a web service, like Gmail, any webmail, Facebook, anything like that. And they allow you to turn it into a clickable icon, which has not all of the rest of the browser stuff all around the outside as far as the different tools, but just what's offered by that web page, and allows you to basically turn any web page into a full screen Mac app. So let me get my face out of the way here. And here are two that I've already created. I'll show you the result before I show you how we do it. So I created for my both the email accounts that I just showed you in the web browser, for my personal email and for the Metro Theater's email, I created little apps. So I double click on this and it opens a browser window, but it's not in a browser. It's basically opening my Gmail, and let me actually minimize the browsers behind it so you can just see how the app itself looks. There it is. So there's the app. You see that you've got just the simple basic app. You've got some tools that you can use as if you were in your web browser. But for the most part, you're just in a single screen email program at this point here, which you can use as email. Now, this is logged into my personal account. If I want to open the Metro Theater's account, I open it up, double click on it, and now it's open. And see, I didn't have to re-log on. I've got both different logins happening at the same time. So I can create multiple email accounts as apps that I double click in, and I can switch back and forth in the taskbar or in any other way. I can just bounce back and forth between the different email apps. That is very slick. Now, how did I create that? I'm glad you asked. Let me show you how I created that. So Fluid is, this is the Fluid app. It's just a little dialog box that you can download. It's free to download, although to do exactly what I'm doing right now, you have to buy the full version at $4.95. And I'm going to walk you through it because there was a couple of tricks that I did that I had to do to make it work perfectly for this. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new one of the icons in order, a new app itself. So I have to give it a URL, and you've got to put in the full URL protocol, FTTP:// and we'll just put in gmail.com, and I am going to name it other email, just other. Okay, so you can actually choose different icons so that it doesn't all have this standard icon. It's created it. I say okay, and here it is up on my desktop right there. So there's my new app ready to go. Now when I open that app, it will open a brand new Gmail session for me. I think maybe it'll open one of the existing ones. It opened the last one that it had because that's what it sees. Now, here's the trick. If you don't do what I do next, it will, whatever the last one you're in, will always open. So the Metro and my Steve one would all open to the same email address unless you go through one setting. And it's not well documented. It's something that I had to figure out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sign out of this one, and then I'm going to sign into my new one, which is for our seminar series. So I'm going to sign into Protectivity. And there it is, it's launching. So this is a brand new account that I've got. Now, what I have to do to ensure that it's going to open in this one each time is I actually have to go into the preferences. Now the preferences are here for Fluid apps. And go into the security tab. As I say, it wasn't supernatural as far as finding this. I have to separate it from Safari. Now what this does is it means that Fluid doesn't look to Safari for its cookies. So it doesn't look to Safari to see exactly what account it is. It's going to store its own. And then I have to actually relaunch it once. But if I do that process and relaunch it again, now every time I open this new one, it will open into this account. That is a very slick way of doing things. Now, as far as managing multiple accounts, these are just four different ways of managing, for the most part, other than the Google app, the Google tool, which allows us to do it within the browser, it's kind of jury-rigging the whole solution. And people go well beyond what I'm doing here. Having multiple Gmail accounts flow into a single unified email client is another good way of managing your multiple accounts, but that doesn't necessarily get you into your documents and other things. Instead of using this as a Gmail account, you could just put this into Google Docs. You could have these little apps that will launch into any other area as well. So there's a variety of different ways that you can manage multiple Gmail accounts. The one thing you don't want to do is have to sign out and re-sign in. There are better ways, and I hope that we've shown you some today. Thanks so much for spending time with me. I'm Steve Dotto.